firmware update over USB-C. Let's look into that. Hi, you're watching Rumour Has It. Please subscribe for camera news, rumour and tutorials. So my Canon R5 eventually arrived, and presumably part of the second batch. It's about 6 weeks later, so I was a bit surprised to find it arrived with 1.0 firmware. However, I decided that was an opportunity, and I'll show you how I go about the process of updating that via USB-C. So I plug the USB-C port in on the camera, and as you can see, the firmware is 1.0. So I'll hop onto a browser here, and we'll go to the Canon website. So I'll just type in Canon firmware EOS R5 and pop down to the Canon website. Now you can see we're on the Canon EOS R5 support site, and if you just look along the various sections, find the one for firmware and click on that. I'm on a Mac, so just make sure that you are selecting the correct operating system, but it does actually recognize the operating system. Yeah, if you click on, you can actually have a look at the release notes on the new firmware, and you can have a read through that. I just clicked the download link, and here we are. It's on a Mac, so you have to go through this bit of process here. But you can see it downloading there. While we're waiting, you can just have a quick look down through the release notes. Not a lot being brought to the camera with this update, at least not that they're telling us about. Just the for the lens 100 to 500 is the main compatibility with that. And we've got the earlier release notes from the 1.1 firmware, which was more substantial. So we'll open up the DMG file here. As I say, on a Mac, so you have this process to go through. And once it unzips, we'll just drag the FIR file onto the desktop. And that's easy to pick up from there. Okay, I'll just type in for the Canon software there, version 3. And we'll just click on to open up the camera settings. There you go. And when we get to this box, we'll click firmware update, and then we just point it to where we put that file on the desktop. And we click for it to go. So it'll ask us to confirm the firmware, and then we click the button again. And here we are. You can see it's transferred that file onto the camera direct. So the current version is 1.00, and the new firmware layer is available to us. You can actually complete the process here on the camera now, so we just go over to select OK, and there it goes. Now don't be surprised, it takes a little bit of time to initialize, so I've sped the film up here, and you can see us now progressing along. We're on 3%. It does take a little bit of time to progress, so I'll not keep you waiting. I'll come back at key stages of the update process just to see how it's going. The whole process doesn't take too long, it's only about a 5 minute process. And here we are back again on 53%, 54%. You can see there are sections that go faster than others. Now we're just closing out on the 100% here. And it's a pretty simple process once this is done. The camera will reinitialize and it'll go back to the camera. Actually, you have to press the button to go to the menu again. I'll just show you that. So we're saying updates complete, 1.00 to 1.1.1. Click OK on that. And as you can see, the camera resets. So it comes back on the actual camera itself here. You have to press the menu button again to bring you back. And as you can see, we'll just scroll down there. We're on version 1.1.1. So really quite a slick process. It doesn't take long at all, about 5 minutes, and it's simple. I just thought I'd cover that because I know a lot of people that are a bit wary of the update process, and also the process involving putting an SD card into the computer and going through that. I've got a MacBook Pro. It doesn't have an SD card slot in it. Because I didn't have that slot at the time, I just thought, well, it says you can do it via USB, let's have a go at that. And it seems to have worked. So I hope you found that useful. Please subscribe to the channel, rumour has it. I'll cover one or two more tutorials in the weeks and months ahead. And also, now that I have the R5 in my hands, I'll give you some updates on that and how it's going for me. And if I do find anything useful, I'll report it back via the channel. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.